Hello everyone, this is Manjula Devi P, Assistant Professor in GFGC Kanakpura. In this session, we are discussing about strategic management of BBA 6th semester, Bangalore University. In that, Unit 2, Environment Appraisal. In the Unit 2, we are talking about the topic SWOT analysis, the very important topic because it's like too common. The moment you are a business graduate or even commerce graduate, so you need to know about what is SWOT analysis. In the interview or even in the practical situations, you'll be coming across with the concept of SWOT analysis in your day-to-day basis. And the beauty of this topic is it is not just restricted to the business context. Even at the personal level, at the individual level, one can do a SWOT analysis. Okay, so let's see what is about SWOT analysis and how to do it. So what are the different variables we consider when we are doing the SWOT analysis? So first and foremost, this is a technique which was developed in 1960s by the Stanford Research Institute. So what is SWOT analysis? It is a strategic management technique to understand the internal and external environment of an organization. Yeah, initially it started with the business context, but later we can also apply it, as I told, at the personal or individual level. So basically it was a technique to understand the internal and external environment of an organization. So, in the previous session, I have already discussed about what is internal and external. Let me just repeat. Internal environment is the environment which is within the organization, which the organization has a considerable control on. Whereas external environment, it is outside the organization and the business concern has very little control or no control over it. For example, your government policies, legal environment, society and culture. So, all those things are external. Internal could be your employees, your management, consumers, competitors. So, they're all can be part of your internal environment. Now, what is this SWOT? SWOT indicates. So, the abbreviation of SWOT is S stands for strength, W is for weakness, O is for opportunity, T is for threat. Sometimes this T is replaced by C, which is nothing but challenges. So they call it as SWOC. But here we are talking about SWOT, which is strength, weakness, opportunity and threat. Now let's see what is the meaning of a strength and what is a weakness, what is opportunity, what is threat. Okay. So now, we generally talk about the term strength, who is very strong. So it is very strength, like maybe the building is very strong or the individual is very strong. That's why weakness, when we say it is like, oh, it is too weak, it may break at any time, or it is very weak. So we may say even the weakness is told even for an individual or for any object, isn't it? Now in the business context, what does this SWOT mean? And how it can be interpreted. Let us see. So the meaning of strength here, okay, in the SWOT, what is the meaning of strength exactly? Strength is an inherent capacity which an organization can use to gain strategic advantage over its competitors. See, strength is something which is internal, which is inherent. Even for an individual to call, he is a strong person, so he need to have that strong build up, isn't it? So his muscle should be strong, he should have that good strength. It is internal, isn't it? If he is just holding a gun, it doesn't make him strong, isn't it? So he may be very weak from inside, but just a gun will not make him a strong person. So to call him as a strong, he has to be strong from within. Same way for an organization. Strength means it's an inherent capacity which organization possess. So that could be the organization is very strong in its research base, or the organization has very good employee base, or the products of the organization is such that it is like it's like the product has evergreen demand, or the service is such that it is essential commodity or service, something like that. So that means it is strength, which is inherent capacity, which is inside the organization. Okay. Then what is the meaning of weakness? Weakness is again something which is inherent. It is a disadvantage. Like as individuals, we say everyone has some weakness, isn't it? Same way organization wise. So what is the disadvantage it has, which is there again within the organization? So weakness is, suppose here the example is over dependence on a single product line. Like the business has only one product. Always when it is only one product, the chances are that if that product loses its demand in the market, or if it gets obsolete, then the entire business gets collapsed. Like the other session I was talking about, HMT watches. Okay, they had very few, like basically it was just watch. There were no other products in the product line. They didn't have clock, or they didn't have any other related products to the wristwatch. They just had wristwatch as the product, and that could be one of the weakness. Okay, so here the weakness could be like they have single product, or maybe their employee retention is very low. There is more employee turnover, or there is the quality of the product itself is low. They have substandard goods. So all those could be the weakness again, which is there within the organization, which may potentially cause a risk for the organization. Okay, that could be a weakness. Then what is an opportunity? Okay, opportunity of course is a favorable condition, okay, in the organization environment, which enables it to consolidate its strength, strengthen its position. Usually opportunity is posed by the external environment, so it's a favorable condition. So it gives you, you know, a chance to strengthen your position and come up in a better way. For example, growing demand for your product, or now in the present context, if I say for all soap manufacturer, there is an opportunity. They can start add one more product line of hand washes, or they can add one more product of say sanitizers, or again all cloth manufacturing can add their product line masks and PPE kits. It's an opportunity because there is growing demand for these things, and within your available infrastructure you can add this one more product. So it is posing you an opportunity, though it's a very crisis situation right now, but that is giving opportunity to some of the business houses, like all your online delivery, online coaching. So it is an opportunity for them to explore this situation, isn't it? So that is an opportunity which is there in the external environment, and through you using your strength, you can grab it and you can gain advantage over it. Then the next thing is threat. So again, the name indicates it's an unfavorable or it's a not so favorable condition in the organization's environment. Again, usually it is posed by an external factor. So what could be a threat? So emergence of new competitors. So there are new competitors coming in your industry. So where your market share might get reduced, or the product what you are dealing with is getting obsolete. So there is new substitute which has come in the market where people are shifting. Okay, so just quote, I want to quote an example of Patanjali here. When Patanjali came, say 5-6 years before, or maybe 10 years before, maybe in 2010 when they entered the market, so then it was actually a threat for all the FMCG companies, because they came up with all varieties like soap, shampoos, toothpaste, like all daily FMCG products, and considerably the quality was good and the price was relatively low compared to the other competitors. So there was a shift in the market. Okay, customers shifted to Patanjali and their sales started increasing. So for other companies, like maybe for Colgate or for any other FMCG, Procter and Gamble or Hindustan Lever Limited, it was a threat. Okay, so that new competitor has come and he is having a better quality with a low price. So it could be a threat. Or threat could be changes in the government policy or the restrictions by the government, increase in the taxation. So all those things could be a threat for a business. So now we saw this SWOT, that is SWOT. What is the meaning of strength? What is the meaning of weakness? What is an opportunity and what is a threat? So strength is an inherent capacity. Weakness is an inherent disadvantage. Opportunity is a favorable condition posed by an external environment. Threat again is an unfavorable condition posed by the external environment. So now every business organization has to do this SWOT analysis at regular intervals so that they get to know what is their inherent strength, weakness, what are the opportunities which are available and what are the probable threats that they are subject to. Because once they know the ground reality, then they can act upon it. Okay. So even in the interviews, if you go as candidates, they may ask your SWOT analysis. Being a candidate, what's your SWOT? So what is your strength? So maybe you have a good knowledge base. Maybe you have good experience in the particular field. All those are your, you're hardworking. Okay. So you don't have time bound. You're ready to work in shifts. So those are all your strengths. What is your weakness? So weakness could be like every individual. So you, what are the weakness that you can pose? So in the sense, like I cannot work for long hours, or I'm not ready to shift to the place. I'm confined to only one geographical locality. That could be your weakness. You cannot shift. You cannot adjust to the new environment, or you're not a team member. You just want to work aloof or alone. Like you don't have that good interpersonal skills. Okay, those could be your weaknesses. Okay, opportunities are like there is more demand for your career. Like you are, say, you are into a medical field. Okay, you are a pharmacist or you are a doctor. There is a great opportunity for you right now. Okay, or you are an engineer who can, you are a researcher who can come up with a new medicine for the present scenario, or you are an engineer who can, who is able to. There is a demand for a particular product or service in your field and you are ready to do it. So that could be an opportunity. Then when it comes to threat could be there are too many candidates in your field, and suppose in the engineering field right now we hear that there are too many engineers than required in the market. So that could be a threat. Or there could be substitute, like M.Tech candidates can get substituted for engineering, or B.Tech is a competition for engineering. So that way, or government comes up with a rule that recently we saw related to engineering, like engineering graduates can be the teachers. So that's a threat for the current B.Ed holders that they'll get competition from the engineering graduates. That could be a threat. Okay. So as individuals also, we can draw our own SWOT analysis so that once we know what is our strength and weakness, then we can tap the opportunities and we can avoid the threats. So what are the steps to conduct this SWOT analysis? First and foremost, setting up the objective of the concerned organization, or what is the objective of your doing the SWOT analysis? Okay. So why basically you want to do it, the basic purpose of it. Then identify. So be very objective in identifying what are the strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats available in the market, at present available for the business. Then prepare a matrix, like put that in four boxes: strength, weakness, opportunities and threat, so that you can clearly see them in one frame. Then work how the opportunities can be tapped through your strengths, as you are having your inherent capability. So how that can be used to grab the opportunities which is available. Then how the threats can be minimized by reducing your weakness or by overpowering your strengths upon it. Okay. So that could be, that is a framework where you can do a SWOT analysis for the business. Even for individuals, on your individual capability also, You can make a SWOT analysis. What are your strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats, and how you can tap the opportunities and how you can reduce the threats, how you can overcome with the weakness, so you can have a plan for it. So first and foremost, you need to know what is the ground reality. So working upon it is secondary. First and foremost, you need to know. Suppose in the interviews and all, they'll ask, what is your SWOT? So you may say a lot of strengths about you, but you may say, no, I don't have any weakness. Then that's absolutely wrong, isn't it? So either you are not ready to share it, or you don't know what is your weakness. Okay, so it's better to know the weakness so that we can work upon it and overcome with it, isn't it? Instead of being ignorant or not accepting the weakness, it's better we accept and then work towards it to overcome with it, isn't it? Then, advantage of SWOT analysis. So what are the, of course, it imposes lot of advantages, because this is something which is gives a source for the strategic planning. Because once you know, again, as an individual, once you know what are your strengths, weakness and opportunities and threats, then you can plan for your future. Okay, you can plan accordingly. Same way for the business, once they know the SWOT, then they can take that as a base for doing the strategic planning. Then once you know your strength, you can work on building it. You can work on improvising your strength. And once you know the weakness, then you can find the ways to reduce it, or find the ways in, you know, dealing with that weakness. Okay, then maximize its response to opportunities. So once you identify what are the opportunities, then you can work on how to grab it, how to maximize it, how to make the best use of that opportunities. And once you know the threats, then you make strategies how to overcome with it. Okay, how to cope with those threats. Then of course, it helps in identifying the core competencies. So core competencies means the basic competency that the business has. Okay, so it helps in identifying it. What is your basic strength? Then helps in setting the objectives for strategic planning. So of course, this entire exercise is done as part of your strategic planning. Of course, it helps in identifying the basic objective. What is that you are doing this entire SWOT analysis? Then the limitations. Of course, SWOT analysis is a great tool for strategic planning. It gives a base, it gives, you know, source of information for taking the strategic decision. But at the same time, not necessarily like it's like 100% error proof or something like that. So of course, it has its own inherent limitations. Like it could be, of course, I do SWOT analysis, but there are many variables which are not in my control. Okay, I'm doing SWOT, of course, I identify what is my strength and weakness, which is there to some extent under my control. But when it comes to opportunities and threats, it's not in my control, isn't it? It may change at any point, as it is part of the external environment. Suppose there is a price increase. So when the price increases, naturally the demand for the commodity decreases. So if the cost of input only is high, then naturally the cost of output would be naturally high, and it may affect your demand pattern. Then the non-availability of raw material, then the government legislation. Government has changed its rules, okay? Maybe the taxation policy, or right now we are facing this lockdown thing. So, like, you cannot overcome with it. You have to be abided by it. Whatever the great plans you had, say you had a lot of, you know, plans, preparations, you had so many things to, you know, do. But it is lockdown. So, you have to be abided by it, isn't it? And the situation, the pandemic situation has come in such a bad way that you can't do anything about it, isn't it? So now it's the time to save the life than thinking about the profit, isn't it? So that could be a limitation. Though you have an excellent SWOT analysis, but ultimately you are just sitting quiet in your house, isn't it? So again, economic environment, when it comes to inflation, when it comes to GDP, when it comes to monetary policy, fiscal policy, these are all beyond your control. Though you are identifying your strengths and weakness and trying to cope with the present opportunities and threats, But a major change in economic variable in the macro level, so you can't do anything about it, isn't it? Then again, searching a new market for the product which is not having overseas market due to import restrictions. So again, maybe in case of your overseas business, there are many variables or factors there in abroad which may not be able to tap in your SWOT analysis. So you are doing a SWOT analysis, but there are many factors which you are not aware. See, it is always like that. Whenever we do this SWOT analysis or any, you know, analysis for that matter, we use the facts, figures and to some amount of assumptions and whatever we perceive. But of course, there may be whole lot of things which is outside this, you know, whatever the matrix or thing we have prepared. We'll get to know only after we experience or only after we take decision and step into the thing, then only we'll get to know. Okay. So likewise, there may be whole lot of things which we might not tap when we are doing the SWOT. Only after we take decision, after we step into it, then we'll come across with those factors. Okay. That could be one of the limitations of SWOT. So I've just given example of strengths and weaknesses, opportunities and threats that the business can have. Of course, you can check online. Every company has its SWOT analysis and like to some extent it's available. Okay, you can see the SWOT of Infosys, the SWOT of any company you type and you'll get, okay, that ready SWOT matrix. And you also try to prepare SWOT of your own. What is your own strengths? What is your weakness? What are the opportunities that you have? Okay, as a BBA graduate, what are the opportunities that will come in your way? And what are the threats? Of course, you have a threat from your close competitor, that is BCom graduates, isn't it? So same way, you have to find out, I mean, you have to make SWOT of your own career. So strengths here, it is again in the business context, technological skill. The company or the organization has a great technological skills. Their brand is a leading brand. Okay, so it's a strength. They have already established that in the market. Then distribution channel, maybe they have an excellent distribution channel. So that's their strength. They have consumer loyalty, like they have created that consumer loyalty in the market where the consumer don't want to shift to some other product. Okay. Then the product quality itself is high. Suppose when we talk about Apple phones, when we talk about Bata shoes, when we talk about Titan watches. So when we talk about any other, like, you know, famous brands, like which is known for its quality. So that is their strength. No matter what is the price, no matter whatever, people would still buy because of that quality, isn't it? That's their strength because they have created that over a period of time. Then the scale of operation. Because scale of operation is very important when it comes to cost per unit or when your profit margin or the selling price. Okay, scale has its own advantage. Okay, so you are working at an optimum scale where you can keep your costs minimum so that you can grab more profit. Then the management, maybe the company has an excellent board of directors, excellent management structure, so which is doing great. That could be your strength. Same way, weakness, maybe your employees are unskilled or technologically you're backward. Your brands are weak, okay, you're not, that's not that famous, or there's no consumer loyalty, there's no retention, your poor, like your distribution channel is not that great, you have a poor channeling, then your products are not that of good quality, so it's unreliable product, then your scale, you're operating at a wrong scale, where which is leading high cost of production, so your profit margins are low, so that could be a weakness. Then the management can be also a weakness. There is a lot of conflict in the management, in the among the board of directors. There's no coordination. Okay, there's no cooperation in the department, between among the departments. So all that could be, you know, a weakness. Then opportunities. So what are the opportunities that you have? Changing consumer taste. Okay, so it could be an opportunity where you can come up with a new product, or you can alter your product and grab the market. Then liberalization of markets. Yes, So after 1991 new economic policy, so it is we have LPG, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization, which gave whole lot of opportunity to the companies to come up. Okay, again the demolition of MRTP Act also gave lot of opportunity for the companies to expand, to go for diversification of their business. So that is an opportunity. Then technical advance, then changes in customer policies, low taxes, change in population age structure, like where you have more youngsters, so you can have more demand for your clothing, footwear and all FMCG product, or there is more amount of childbirth, so there is more demand for all this sophisticated children baby products. Okay, so likewise any change that happen in the external environment, you can look it as an opportunity. Okay, it is like a perception what you look at it. You can see it as an opportunity if you have an inner strength to grab it, or you can see it as a threat if you are loaded with weakness. Okay, so it's like a situation can be an opportunity or can be a threat depending on how you see it. Okay, same way threats could be, see, it's like base same product. Changing consumer taste can be an opportunity if you are ready to work on the new product and you give new services, if you are ready to improvise. But same thing can be a limitation, where if you are rigid, you are not changing. Okay, so like I gave example of HMT. So maybe they didn't want to change, or they didn't, there were many other issues with it. So it had to close because the taste of the consumers towards the wristwatches have changed. Then again, I want to give one more example of Atlas Bicycles. Okay, it was once upon a time, it was a very famous brand bicycle. Okay, it was actually a dowry element again to the bridegroom. They used to give Atlas cycle as a one of the gift from the bright side. Okay, but today the market for bicycle has completely changed. Bicycle is not used as a mode of transport, like maybe a very little percentage. Bicycle is mainly used for entertainment, like for and exercise, for such purposes, isn't it? Then the design, the style, the efficiency, the thing has to change according to the new demand, new taste of the consumers. If they're not changing, if they had only one type of bicycle, one brand, then naturally they had to go out of the market. So same way, closing of markets, like if the government imposes restriction on that particular market, then of course it's a threat. And yeah, most of the time you can't do anything about it if it is a policy matter. Then again, technological advances. Again, if you are not ready to change according to the new technology, of course, it poses a threat for you. Your product and service becomes obsolete. Then political instability, again, you can't do anything about it. Of course, it's a threat. Then high rate of taxes, then aggressive competition, the huge competition in the market where there are too many new entrants and coming up with the new products and services, which is giving a tough competition for you. Then shortage of resources, of course, is a threat, where though you have equipped with everything, but there are no resources, to convert into goods or service, then of course it's a threat. So these are some of the examples of SWOT SWOT: strength, weakness and opportunity and threats that a company can have. Again, each company can come up with their own SWOT. Suppose if you talk about company XYZ, so they may have their own SWOT. Like an individual can have his own or her own SWOT analysis. Okay. So just to recap, so in this session, we discussed about one of the very important aspect topic, SWOT analysis, where SWOT stands for strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. It is important at the business level for taking strategic decisions about the business, and of course at the individual level for his own mapping about where he actually stand. Okay, so this was mainly SWOT gives the source of information for strategic decisions, and Though the strengths and weakness are internal, opportunities and threats are external, but by using the internal strength, the external opportunity can be trapped, and by reducing the weakness, the threats can be handled. So they're all interlinked, okay? So a company has to work towards improvising the strength, even an individual for that matter, and reduce the weakness. First of all, identify the weakness and then work on how to overcome with it. And look for opportunities always, what is there present in the market, and try to manage the threats with your internal strength. So these are all So hope you understood the concept. We'll meet in the next session. Thank you very much.